ಶ್ರೀಮಾನ್ ವೆಂಕಟನಾಥಾರ್ಯ ಕವಿತಾರ್ಕಿಕ ಕೇಸರಿ ವೇದಾಂತಾಚಾರ್ಯವರ್ಯೋ ಮೇ ಸನ್ನಿಧತ್ತಾಂ ಸದಾ ಹೃದಿ. ಆನ್ ದಿ ಒಕೇಶನ್ ಆಫ್ ದಿ ಸೆಂಟಿನರಿ ಸೆಲೆಬ್ರೇಷನ್ ಆಫ್ ಶ್ರೀಮತ್ ಪರವಾಕ್ಕೋಟ್ಟೈ ಆಂಡವನ್ ಶ್ರೀ ಗೋಪಾಲ ದೇಶಿಕ ಮಹಾದೇಶಿಕನ್, ಅಡಿಯೇನ್ ಇಸ್ ಹಿಯರ್ ಟು ಪ್ರೆಸೆಂಟ್ ಅ ಶಾರ್ಟ್ ಉಪನ್ಯಾಸಂ ಅಬೌಟ್ ದಿ ಗ್ರೇಟ್ನೆಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಸ್ವಾಮಿ. ವಿ ಆಲ್ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಗೋಲ್ಸ್ ಇನ್ ಲೈಫ್ ಅಂಡ್ ವಿ ಪರ್ಸ್ಯೂ ಅ ಪಾತ್ ವಿಚ್ ಗೈಡ್ಸ್ ಅಸ್ ಟುವರ್ಡ್ಸ್ ದಿ ಗೋಲ್. Guides who are bearing the torch of knowledge and taking us along the path of righteousness will help us reach the goal called ultimate bliss. Such great guides are none other than our preceptors or acharyas. One such great Sri Vaishnava Acharya was Sri Gopala Desika Mahadesikan Swami. Swami incarnated on this earth about 100 years ago in a Raudri Varsham when the month was Panguni and the star was Rohini. This dates back to 17th March 1921. Great people incarnate on this earth on a momentous occasion. It was indeed a very momentous occasion when this Swami descended down on earth too. It was the day of the car festival or Tiruther of Rajagopala Swami. And because of this reason, our Swami also was named as Rajagopala. Incidentally, his grandfather's name too was Rajagopala. Swami's ancestors were ardent disciples of Sri Periya Andavan and Veliyanallur Andavan Swamigal. Swami's father was Sri Venkatacharya Swami, who was known to be a great Acharashila, that is, the one having great faith in scriptural practices, and was also an intellectual giant who did regular kalakshepams or spiritual learning from his acharyas. Belonging to the Vadulam Kandadai clan, spiritual inclination was inborn in Rajagopala. Rajagopala lost his mother when he was barely 2 years. His mother attained Paramapada Prapti, but his father made up for everything and was his mother and father and brought him up with great care, affection, at the same time enforcing the required amount of discipline. It is said that Swami got his Upanayanam Samskaram done at the age of 7, and after that his father ensured that he always did Udayopasthanam, that is, he performed his morning Sandhya Vandanam at the ordained time by the scriptures, and he did this every day. And he also ensured that Rajagopala Swami did not eat from anywhere outside, Parannatyajyam as it is called, because we all know that food or aharam is the basis on which we assemble our thoughts and gather energy from it. So only if food is sattvic in nature, one can harbor sattvic thoughts. So it is an important spiritual practice to offer food to God and partake it as prasadam. And only the food which is prepared with great devotion and purity is worth offering to God. And so it is best to avoid food from any and every source. So this aspect of Paranna Tyajyam was instilled effectively into the mind of young Rajagopala by his father. And this child would not have food from outside right from the age of 7 years. He was also taught all kinds of achara practices like having ordained baths, wearing Dwadasha Pundra, speaking with humility and respect to elders and his fellow beings. With such rich values, this child was brought up. After his Upanayanam, he learnt Kavya and Nataka from Mahakavi Krishnamacharya for a span of 3 years. The next 1 year he spent at Scholinger College learning advanced aspects of literature. After this, for a span of 6 years, Rajagopala Swami did an advanced course in Shiromani at Tirupati Venkateshwara College. At this time, he was staying at Ahobilamat, which is present in Kil Tirupati or Lower Tirupati as it is called. Here, he gained association with great people like Purusai Krishnamachar Swami, Villivalam Narayanachar Swami, Sri Melpakkam Swami, Sri Marudur Krishnamacharya Swami. These people were spiritual giants of those times. Why those times? Of all times, even today. And R. Rajagopala Swami also joined their band. Sri Rajagopala Swami was very popular amongst his comrades. He was known to be approachable, intelligent, and at the same time, he gained the respect of his classmates. This was because his practice of achara was very, very impact creating to his friends. In fact, his friends would often call him as Sage Vasishta for being so particular about following the scriptures. After he thus completed his education, he came back home and found that his father was ailing. Just a couple of days before his father attained Paramapadam, he called his son beside him and told him something very important. He said, "My dear son, I want you to go and do Vedanta Kalakshepam from Sri Parakalamat Swami at Mysore." So, fulfilling his father's last wish, Rajagopala Swami went to Mysore and learnt Vedanta Shastra from Sri Abhinava Ranganatha Brahmatantra Parakala Swami for a span of 5 years. From the year 1942 to 1947, Swami was in Mysore. At this time, he could also learn some aspects of Vedanta from Dikshachar, who was known to be proficient at the subject at that time. Swami came out with flying colors at Vedanta Deshika Vihara Sadas, which was held by Mysore Samasthana at that time. After this, Rajagopala Swami entered the wedlock, where he got married to Thirukkudandai Arubadi Chetlur Srinivasa Acharya Swami's daughter. It is notable that Swami's mother-in-law, Rajagopala Swami's mother-in-law, was the cousin of Devanar Vidagam Srimad Aragya Singer, the 43rd pontiff of Sri Ahobilamat. Swami then worked as a Sanskrit teacher in some schools at Trichy. He often used to visit Srirangam to have darshan and blessings of his Acharya Sri Paundrikapuram Swami. Looking at his ardent devotion, faith in scriptures, and uncompromising effectiveness of achara practices, his acharya decided to tell him to take up the sannyas ashrama. It was the wish of Sri Vennatrankarai Andavan Swami that Rajagopala Swami takes up asceticism or the sannyas ashrama. Accordingly, on 22-1982, Rajagopala Swami took up the sannyas ashrama. It was a Durmati year, the month being Masi, the 8th day. It was a Dwadashi Tithi, where the star, the prevailing star, was Purvashada. Rajagopala Swami now became Sri Gopala Desika Mahadesikan. He was presented the Kashaya, that is the ascetic robe, and Kamandalu, the divine vessel, from Parakalamat, Mysore, as the prasadam of Sri Lakshmi Hayagriva. Thus accepting sannyasashrama, Swami moved on to perform kainkaryams in this ashrama too. The Rajagopuram at Srirangam was being built at this time, and Sri Gopala Mahadesika Swami authored a book named Gopura Darshanam Koti Punyam. He distributed these books amongst his sishyas, and the collection that was got as a result of this was used in building the 12th tier of the Rajagopuram. Swami was also responsible for the construction of the Brindavanam of Sri Velliyanallur Andavan Swami at Vennatrangarai. Swami brought about renovation of the ashrama and built quarters for staff to reside in. That was a great move by Swami, who had intense compassion for his sishyas. At the time of Swami's kainkaryam, many lords or Utsava Murtis came to the ashrama. For example, Sri Lakshmi Hayagriva Murti was given by Amma Satram Swami's grandson. As a result of Swami's immense devotion, all lords wanted to come to him and receive Thiruvaradhanam from his hands. Swami was a very soft-spoken person and spent all his time in giving to the devotees. He would give knowledge to the devotees. He would give guidance to the devotees. He would give advice to the devotees. And this he not only did by preaching Kalakshepams, but also by authoring a number of books. He has authored different editions of Srimad Rahasyatraya Saram, Chilrai Rahasyangal, and Swami has also written a number of books regarding explanation of Desika Stotrams. One such occasion when Swami was authoring commentaries to Desika Stotrams, an anecdote was quoted to me by my revered father, Sri Uve Devanar Vilagam Saranathacharyar Swami. Sri Saranathan Swami told me that he visited the ashrama to get blessings of Gopala Desika Mahadesikan Swami. And at that time, Swami was writing a commentary for the Achyuta Shatakam by Swami Desikan. It seems that Swami used to always refer to Chetlur Swami's Vyakhyanam or explanation before he penned down a Vyasam for any Stotram. Apparently, at that time, Swami was not able to get hold of Chetlur Swami's Vyakhyanam for the Achyuta Shatakam. So, he asked Saranathan Swami if it could be procured from some source, if he knew of anybody who possessed a copy of Chetlur Swami's Vyakhyan. At that time, Saranathan Swami was not aware of anybody having the Vyakhyanam, but he told the Acharya that he would try his level best to get hold of some information in this regard. Saying so, Saranathan Swami returned back to his abode and using some sources that he had, he was able to procure a copy of Chetlur Swami's Vyakhyanam for Achyuta Shatakam, which he promptly sent to Sri Gopala Desika Mahadesikan Swami through some known contact, and the book reached Srirangam in some time. By the time all this happened, our Swami, Sri Gopala Desika Mahadesikan Swami, had got a copy of Chetlur Swami's Vyakhyanam from another source. So he had already procured the book, which now came to him the second time from Saranathan Swami. Saranathan Swami says, Swami was so gracious to write a letter and send it to him, saying that he was very thankful to him that he sent the book and that he had already procured another copy from another source. Now, something that needs to be understood from this episode is that a person in a high position doesn't find himself answerable to a common man. But our Swami was an epitome of Atmagunas. He was somebody who had such humility that he found it his responsibility to answer and thank a devotee who came forward to provide some service to him. A service which actually he had received from some other source, so was actually redundant to him. Despite the fact that he had the book before itself, Swami very courteously conveyed to Saranathan Swami that he had received another copy from another source and that he was very thankful to the effort that Saranathan Swami took to send him the book. Such was the Atmaguna of Swami. It is said that Swami was also very particular about teaching the principles of Acharam to his disciples. It so happened that some devotees came to take darshan of Swami at Srirangam once. And these people had a child along with them, a child of maybe 5 to 6 years. And at the time the child was present in front of Swami, the child put his finger on his lips. Swami immediately called the child's parents and told them that this is not correct. Keeping your finger on the lips will lead to echal, and the hand needs to be washed immediately. Swami added by saying that do not think that he is just a child and can be left like that. So what if a child is trying to put a finger on his lips? It's not a big deal. He's a child after all. He will learn when he becomes big. That could be the thought process in the minds of many people. So says Swami. But please understand that any practice that you teach a child will remain with him forever. They say in Tamil, Pasumarathu Aani, meaning if you try to nail a green tree, the nail will remain there forever. So any practice which is given at an early stage, at a young age, will be remembered forever. So please teach the practices of Achara to your children when they are young. Do not think that they are young now and that they will learn later. Later learning comes with great difficulty. Sometimes it doesn't come at all. So, please ensure that you teach your children practices from a young age. So, go and teach a child that he's supposed to wash his hands if he puts his fingers on his lips, and unnecessarily he should not be putting his finger on the lips unless it is really needed. At the time of eating, you need to put the finger on the lip and eat, after which you will wash your hand. But at other times, there is no need to take the finger near the lip. It could lead to acharyan. So please avoid such things and teach your child to wash the hand immediately. This was the instruction given by Swami to his disciples. Thus, our Swami was a living example of an exemplary acharya. The definition of an acharya is very beautifully given in our scriptures. Achinotihi shastrarthan achare sthapayatyapi swayam acharate yasmat tasmat acharya uchyate. Meaning, an acharya is the one who preaches, who gives upadesha, upadesha of the shastras, meaning of the shastras. Achinotihi shastrarthan. He is the one who establishes righteous practices. Achare sthapayati. And how does he establish practices? Not just by preaching the meaning, not just by telling people to follow it, but by being a leading example who follows it himself. Swayam acharate. Swami was the one who gave upadesha of achara, who established the principles of achara, and who himself followed the practice of achara to the letter as given by the scriptures. So on this great occasion, let us all beseech the blessings of this great acharya, Sri Gopala Desika Mahadesika Swami, and attain ultimate bliss. Kavitarkika Simhaya Kalyana Gunashaline Srimate Venkateshaya Vedanta Gurave Namaha.